I'm so excited that you joined here this morning. Today we're going to be looking at the famous true story of Jesus feeding more than 5,000 people. As we talk about the feeding of the 5,000, we'll be looking at how every day we can trust Jesus. But before we check out the story, how about we sing along together? So go ahead, stand up and sing with us. Awesome. Thanks for singing along. Now let's dive into the Bible story.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus feeds the 5,000. This is Jesus.
Hey-o!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He did many miracles and healed people of their sickness. A huge crowd kept following him wherever he went because they saw his miraculous signs as he healed the sick. A crowd started to gather around Jesus. There were 5,000 men and many more women and children. Turning to Philip, he asked,
"Hey, Philip!
Where can we buy bread to feed all these people?" You see, Jesus was testing Philip, for he already knew what he was going to do. Philip replied, "Even if we worked for months, we wouldn't have enough money to feed them."
Hey, I got an idea.
Then Andrew spoke up. "There's a young boy here with 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good is that with this huge crowd?" Jesus said, "Tell everyone to sit down." Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks to God, and gave them to the people.
There you go.
Afterward, he did the same with the fish. and they all ate as much as they wanted.
Want some more?
I'm all good, thanks.
After everyone was full, Jesus told his disciples, "Now gather the leftovers, so that nothing is wasted."
You got it.
So they picked up the pieces and filled 12 baskets with scraps, left by the people who had eaten from the 5 barley loaves and 2 fish.
Jesus took 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish and used them to feed over 5,000 people. What an incredible miracle. Let's go into this story just a little deeper.
In the story of Jesus feeding the 5,000, I'm sure those people felt like they were starving. They had been following Jesus around all day, and it was getting pretty late. So by that point, they were probably really hungry. You might get super hungry if you even miss one meal. So we can only imagine how these people must have felt. And 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish split 5,000 ways doesn't seem like it would be a very fulfilling meal, but that's what Jesus had. And so he prayed over it, and he started passing it out. And then, to everyone's surprise, he kept passing out more. And he passed out some more. And he kept passing out this food until over 5,000 people were full and they couldn't eat anymore. Talk about an incredible miracle. Jesus is absolutely amazing. He was able to take a little boy's lunch and use it to feed thousands. Not long after Jesus had multiplied the fish and bread for the thousands of people, Jesus told all of those following him something very important. In John 6:35, Jesus says, "I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst." Jesus said that he is the bread of life. Now, when you first hear that, it can sound kind of weird, because it's kind of odd that someone says that they're like bread. But what does that mean for us? Well, in the same way that your stomach gets hungry, your spirit gets hungry too. But they don't sell spirit food at the store, so how are we supposed to feed our spirit? What Jesus is saying in this verse is that when you spend time with him, it's like you are eating food. Every time you pray, it's like you are eating that spiritual food. Every time you read the Bible, it's like you're eating more of that food. And every time you live how Jesus taught you all to live, it's like you are eating that spiritual food. Our spirits get hungry, and the only thing that can feed them and make them strong is Jesus. Jesus is the one we need. We need to spend time with Jesus because he is the bread of life.
Just like our bodies need food, our spirit needs food, and the only thing that will fill us spiritually is our relationship with Jesus. So, what does the time look like that you spend with Jesus? Do you have a specific time or a specific place that you go to? If you don't, maybe you can start considering doing that. This is the way we can receive spiritual food from him. Well, that's it for this week. Let's close with a song, and we'll see you next week. Hope you have an amazing week. Bye, BCC Kids. We'll be right back.